curious about how I can create free form surface defined by six curves this way as a full parametric object, and how can I do some modifications of this object to another figure like this. That means I move one vertex into a direction and I rotate something inside the surface. So the starting point are some curves. They should be Bezier curves, and I need three in one direction. I call them the ribs of the object, the green ones, and the other three are the meridians, and from those I want to create the surface. And here's the grid of the surface. The surface will go through these six curves. Okay, what can I do? First thing is I create six sketches. These sketches are simple polygons. Which have some degrees of freedom. Okay, the next step, I use these six sketches and create Bezier curves of them. So now when I change such a figure, I see the curve follows the figure. So the figures are still parametric, and now I can hide the sketches, and I create from these six curves a compound. I have to switch to the part workbench. Okay, this is the compound, then I go back. And the next step is I create from this a Gordon surface. This takes some seconds. So I still display some helper objects. Oh, I see there is something is wrong here on this. So I delete the compound. Yes, I delete all these things, and I have to go back to part. So when I have to select 1, 2, 3 in the right order, and the next is this, then 5 and 4. So I repeat it all, go back, and now I take the next try. So now I have the right order, I hide the helper surfaces, and I see this is the Gordon surface of this compound. So I can make a grid, a map of the face, and I can hide the surface, and I see this is the grid of the created Gordon surface. So the next step, I now want to do some modifications. That means I look at a sketch, say I look at this sketch, and now I do a modification of the sketch. I drag this away and I see the surface changes, it's full parametric. I can do the same here. Okay. The same I can do with the other sketches. The next step is I want to modify this surface. So I select it and I start the surface editor. And in this case, I select these two corners. And now I can move them a little bit around. I can say I move them into Z direction. And the next thing what I do is I do some rotation with the tangents. And I go back. And I do a movement in Y direction. Okay, and I apply and close it. And I see the result. This is the result, the new one. And I look what is the map of the face. And now I can compare this map with the map of the Gordon surface. And so I can see the differences between both surfaces. I change the color to see the difference. We see in this area we have overlapping. Both grids are the same. And here in this area we have some modifications. And what we also can see, the edge here is not a planar face, that a planar curve. That means it cannot be created or defined by a sketch. So I have here really a 3D modification of the surface. This last step from the Gordon surface to this new result surface is a non-parametric step, because I have too many data which can be changed. I can change for any of these poles about 12 parameters, and so it doesn't make sense to make this step parametric. This is a step of an artistic step, and I think there should not be a parametric.